Welcome back, or welcome for the first time, to TM1 Bytes Weekend Edition, 24 days out from the Phoenix GP. The first time we have raced there, a beginning and an end, because this will be the last of the lead-up episodes in the European Racing Series for us, unless we really screw up next year and end up getting demoted the following year. But I think this will be it for us, so we are going to be going to a track that we know very little about. During the last race, as we know, Bjorn Bjelland stepped in for Sarah Thomas because Sarah was a bit of a mess and still is a bit of a mess. We go over and take a look at her. She still has a banged up face and a dodgy neck. And she's also had her house burned down, so she's minus one on everything. And also, if her affair is discovered, which still has 3 weeks to run, she will end up being minus two on everything, which will make her minus three on everything. I would not count on Bjorn failing to make another appearance in the final race in the ERS, but we shall see how that goes. Let's head on over to the mail call. Porter top with Bjelland behind. Car condition update. I was going to say, don't expect to see that again, but maybe you will. 12 hours. We have no further parts to build. We have no further work in the factory to do. It's just basically make, work, and practice at the moment. Hank Lipman, what would you like to know? Your driver, Max Porter, has won the title. Congratulations. Why, thank you. Any comments for us about the winning driver? Max Porter has done brilliantly. Yeah, he's done pretty well. And he deserves every last drop of champagne. No, he doesn't. The rest of us have basically put him up there. He's risen on our shoulders. He's done well this season, but he's been supported by a great team. Damn straight he has. The driver is just one part of the overall team. He may have won the title, but it belongs to the guys back at the HQ. Well, sort of. But, I mean, I'm not going to pee on Max if it wasn't for his driving skills. Although he was actually below his best for most of this year after having done the swinging on the chandelier thing. He's done well this season, but he's been supported by a great team. That would actually improve Thomas's morale a little bit if it wasn't 100% already. So let's finish the interview there. Pit crew review. We had one mistake. Thank you, Assie. Yeah, we're going to do the pit crew in a moment. Porter wins the Black Sea GP. Sure, let's go over and do the pit crew. Alrighty, so we're going to be going back to the A team this time. Let me just bring up the splash screen. Now, I've actually changed my mind about Brittner because Brittner is back to 0% mistake chance. She's still five down on stamina, but it should be good enough to put her in for the last race of the season. Felipe and Montagnier will be going into the fixing because if Bjorn does race, I'm going to be doing the same thing again, which is stripping his engine. The engine is critical in Phoenix, that's right, down to the bone and then getting him to do a part fix. So I want Felipe and Montagnier in there. They're our 15-16 team. Picardi and Benacau 15-16 on the refueling. So the time will drop from what would have been 13.33 under the existing team to 13.68 under the existing team to 13.33. So we gain 0.35 of a second. I shall speed through this and come back to you after it's done. Okay, that's all done now. And as we can see, 13.334. Okay, it's a rounding issue. We've got to take a look at the highs. Okay, let's take a look here. 5.14. 5.7. Nope. And nothing to write home about in the jacks either. This guy might actually raise himself up to 15 on the front jack, but I've got enough jack people, and in fact, I'm going to let one of them go. So let's get rid of all of these. Clear, 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 go away. Pit crew. Now, what I'm also going to do is renew everybody's contract, because this is one of the less desirable things about the game, that you do not get a warning before they finish, and there's two races to go. I can't remember how many are in APS next year, but I want to re-renew maybe halfway through the season. So obviously Leonardi is somebody who I'd like to have more of. Brittner, Top Gun, even though she has screwed up once this year, she's going to be renewed. Felipe, yep, okay, he's expensive, but that fixing stat, and also the fact that he can back up on rear jack, also he's 14 on tyres, I want more of those, not fewer. Abedio, sayonara. No, this he drops back to 0.1 when he's so you use him only once every two times. Not acceptable. Too expensive. Fixing is crap. Refueling is crap. Yes, he does have that front jet characteristic, but Seda can do that. Seda is 1 point lower, but I don't really care. At least Seda isn't costing me as much. He's costing me, what, 7,000, and I'm losing 1 point. I'm going to take Seda. I'll do a quick skim through this after this and just make sure. Actually, I'll do it now in just a moment. Okay, just double-check that. I've got everybody except for Abadio, who I don't particularly want to get. But you know who else we need to rehire for next year? It is Mr. Freddy Cooper Federico. Let's renew your... What? You know that intricate plan that we had for next year where Freddy would boost up our gearbox and our brakes and give us great carryover parts? Yeah. Not yet. Not yet. I have a couple of plan Bs in mind. Cancel that off. When's the headquarters going to be done? We're going to be finished building the wind tunnel in 12 weeks. It's already November, so that won't be until the new year. Freddy's contract will expire at the end of the year. So I either sack him now and get somebody else, or I wait until that expires naturally. So we don't have to commit to building the brakes building just yet. We needed to build the wind tunnel anyway. So if we don't have anybody who's particularly good in brakes, we could pivot to a different building. Excuse me a moment. I want to check something. All right. I just went back and reloaded some of the past games. Now, I know that Freddy was prepared to talk to us earlier this year. I only left him and didn't renew him because I didn't want to give him a pay cut earlier than I needed to. In August, just after Guildford, he was interested. In September, just after Tondela, he was interested. And we had just finished building the last of the parts at that point. In October, after race night at Milano, he became not interested. Now, there are a couple of different possibilities here. The first is that if you leave your designer without work for a couple of months, then maybe they'll lose interest, feel like they're wasting their time. The other is that, and I haven't seen this happen before, but I haven't actually checked how close to the end I've renewed some people. I'm pretty sure in 2016 I left it right down to the last minute to renew my drivers, but it could be that if you leave it too close to the expiry date, there's a chance that they won't be interested. Now, just out of curiosity, I tried setting him to work on a new part after race 9 and then ran it forward for a few weeks and asked again, but it didn't change his mind, but the damage may have been done. So I have a sneaking suspicion that it may well be how close to the close of contract it is that has triggered this. Now, lesson in this, boys and girls, be a bit ruthless. Even if it's not in your staff member's interest, if you know that you're going to rehire them straight away. Yeah, I'll figure out what to do about Freddy later. I've got a couple of ideas. But we shall see how that goes. Okay, I'm going to start moving on. I'm not going to look at any of the scouting reports this time around. What I will do, though, is just make sure that Sylvia has plenty of work to do. And she does seem to have plenty of work to do. But just in case, World Motorsport Championship, let's sort by Racing Series Asia Pacific Super Cup. Is there anybody in there who hasn't been scouted at this point? Doesn't appear to be. So there's a couple in progress. Check queue. We've got a couple in here for GT Challenger. I'll just add them in. Add him in. Or I don't know whether it was him or her. I didn't look. Scout driver. And that seems to be the lot of them. There should be a fresh lot coming through at the end of the year. But as for the scouting itself, we'll take a look at that at the end of the episode. Also, we do have slot 3 coming up for sponsorship renewal. Let's continue on. Well, that was fast. Okay, let's take a look. Oh, we've got 3 sponsors already. Car repair is finished. I don't think there is anything that we have to do with the car. Improved parts, I'm just letting these guys... Right, they'll be finished 5 days after the race. That's fine. I don't need to hear from them again. Let's take a look at the sponsorship already. Slot 3 is the high-performance slot. There are only first and second as the target options available in this slot. And in this case, it's all first. Okay, so We do not have a chance in hell of getting up to first place in APS early next year, and I'm not going to risk it for... No, I'm not going to risk it. We can get 1 million for coming third. We will come third, at least. So there's no point in risking it. I learnt the lesson in humility at Tondela. Okay, so Viking, 2 million up front. Cupcake, 400,000 up front. Ishikawa, 1 million up front. Obviously, we're going to take the 2 million simply because we are not, come APS, going to be in contention for any of these payments over the course of these deals. So we'll accept the Viking offer. There's an extra 2 million into our kick. 15.3 million. We will go through that money. What's coming up? Nothing much. Let's go. Okay, we've got a couple of scouting reports. Okay, we'll take a look at those at the end, as I said. Is that it? APS. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. We're not in APS yet. Okay, Winston. Bloody Margate again. With pole position and fastest lap. 14 points. Here he comes, charging up the outside, threatening Landvik's position. And possibly even Amura's, but I don't think you'll catch Bergman. Landvik actually came second in that race, and Freya Larsson from Spirit GP came third. So in terms of the team standing, Spirit GP is, wow, only 4 points ahead of McNeil with one race to go. Grand final time for the next race. Thornton can also still make an appearance there. I would say that Eastwood is going to be heading back to ERS. I don't think there's any doubt about that, but there's only 3 points in it. We'll see. Let's continue on. What's coming up? Scouting reports, WMC at the end of the week. Let's go. Oh, Lord. Problems with another driver. Max Porter. Marvin Bachmann is being an absolute nightmare. He is a little bit. Not only does he constantly belittle me but when talking to the press, but now he says I'm not ERS material. What should I do? You're not ERS material. You're APS material. That's why I hired you. Let me have a think about this. Okay. This is unfortunate because this is actually the same dilemma where Faith picked up the racer characteristic, plus two on everything. And that would have been really cool to have for little Max. But it's not what we've got. We've got either aggressive, which adds plus two to overtaking, or get your head down, hard worker is plus 15 to the mechanic relationship and plus one to fitness. Now, little Max actually has pretty good fitness. It's 13. But overtaking, he could go to 18 then, and with his first lap hero, which is plus four on everything, he'd actually overload on that. He would be over 20 in his overtaking. Maurizio's not going anywhere in the foreseeable future, although he's progressing more slowly than I would like. Fitness would get into 14. No, I'm going to take overtaking. So that'll give him a plus two. So what will that give him? Aggressive. Channel your anger into racing. All right. We take a look at little Max now. He is now 18 in overtaking. Right. I would have preferred something that gave him more smoothness. But unfortunately, that was not to be. What's coming up? WMC, let's go. Hey, Bindo Giuliani. Oh, Italian. We'll check him out at the end. Let's not get distracted. Well, the good news is that two of the three podium positions are Scuderia Rossini. The bad news is that the top position goes to Steinman. 300 points. I think we can put the glasses down and call it over. Okay, Zoe Sharp came second. Harry Chapman came third. That's interesting. They don't seem to have pole position bonuses or top speed bonuses in WMC. Interesting. Over in the teams area, 344 versus 451. That's pretty much stuffed it. Rosado Corsa, 15. Team Kirov, 12. So Team Kirov has one last chance to overhaul Rosado Corsa and save themselves from APS next year. Let's go. Oh, dear Lord. You know what I saw in the mail, don't you? Teams Championship target update. No, not that. This is, I come to expect this. I just basically filter this noise out. Report on upcoming race, Phoenix. 30-lap race. Lap length is 2.64. Lap record is 122.643, which is kind of interesting considering that no competition has ever raced on this particular incarnation of the Phoenix track before. Unsurprisingly for Phoenix, the race should be bone dry. Well, duh. With a 0% chance of rain. That's what happens when you race in the middle of a desert. It's a high-speed circuit, which should suit cars with strong engines. Enough S's in that sentence, Diego. Firebird MRT currently wants to beat there. The tyre compounds are soft and medium, and in single race practice sessions that I have done, regardless of the team that I picked to do the single race practice session, you do not get away with doing softs all the way through on this one. Track is quite abrasive, which it is. Our car is one of the best on the grid, blah, blah, blah. We should be well placed to benefit from that. Yeah. Okay, so I have done some practice on it with single race things at the front menu, but it's still a little bit of an unknown quantity in terms of racing against the other ERS members, obviously. Car feedback. When you compare it to the rest of the ERS, our car is average at best. Really? Really, Diego? Our car is average at best. Position, first. Best on grid. That is where we suck. What were we saying, Little Max? You can't expect me to put in my best performances ever when I'm working with inferior material. You mean the car that you always describe as being the best car ever? I know we can do better. Yes, we can do better. Maybe design a few new parts. Well, yeah, we are going to next year. Make some improvements to the ones we already have, which are all maxed out. Is Thomas having an affair? That's what I saw. Here we go. Sarah Thomas has set the gossip columns alight after being spotted out for a night on the tiles with hunky celeb Wendy Spence. This can't be good for her hunky celeb Wendy Spence? If he's hunky, why does he have a girl's name? It's girly man. This can't be good for a driver, said noted ex-driver Fabio Torino. No, I don't do good Schwarzenegger accents either. It's only going to be a distraction. I was having affairs. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, okay. Minus two on everything for 19 weeks. The good news, such as it is that the majority of that 19 weeks is going to expire over the interseason. But it does raise the question. We have seen AI drivers who have not had their affair exposed, but I have yet to see one of my drivers not have their affair exposed. Scouting report is finished. Pre-race bites. Bjorn Bjelland has been tipped as the driver to... How are you typing that with a straight face, Giro? Former WMC driver Michael Tellman has claimed Bjorn is looking great this weekend. How do you know I'm even going to race, Bjorn? I mean, yes, obviously I am. That's a foregone conclusion, buddy. But, second place driver Thomas is hoping to close the gap on Scuderia Quantistica's Porter. Notwithstanding that if I race Bjorn, obviously Thomas won't be there. Actually, this is an interesting point. It's time to start reeling him in. The thought of beating Porter is what gets me up in the morning. You get up with a broken neck and a beaten-up face, Sarah. You're not going anywhere, and you're probably going to lose second as a result of that. Rolando Camara has claimed that a podium finish is doable for silver. Who knows? Maybe. Like I said, it's the undiscovered country. Scouting report's finished. I think we don't have anything else, do we? No, it's travel to Phoenix. So let's take a look at those scouting reports. Okay, Alice Wood. What's all the minuses? Burglary, minus one. Her stats have peaked, 36. Aha. Not going backwards yet, though. She's sort of... She was a potential four-star, but she just didn't make it. Okay, hates authority. Don't like that characteristic. That makes it too much like hard work. Pay driver's good. Went with a struggler. She's got feedback of 16. And a pay driver. 36, no. For a one-year contract to replace Bjorn, 16, and she would actually be a decent backup driver. She won't talk to us at the moment because, obviously, Lockhart, which competition is that? She won't talk to us anyway. IGTC, GT Challenger Series will talk to us once we get into APS because they're level 2, we're level 2, but not at the moment, and not IGTC, they're level 1, they'll only talk to WMC. Oh well, never mind. Hannah Trenoweth, hopefully no relation to Paul, Drift Champion Action Averse, age 21, marketability 24, and that's with the Drift Championship thing. Nothing really desirable here. She has no stars for improvement. Next. Okay. Okimoto. Feedback blows. Stats of Pete. 30 years old. Half a star. Will not grow into it. Is a mentor. Is a chaser. Not what we need. 33%. Goodbye. Bindo Giuliani. Italiano. 25. Expensive. Wet weather pro. Early breaker. That's bad. Passionate, desired earnings, that's good. Endurance championship, consistency and marketability, 93%. Hello. Frustrated reserve. His only weak point is fitness. Too much pasta. And he's got half a star to grow into. It's expensive, but he might race for less if he was getting a main. Oh, hell. ITTC, he's not going to talk to us, even once we get into APS. Well, just in case he ends up being booted out of there and goes to another team, we'll keep him in mind. Gaspar Fuentes, born leader, he's chasing sim racing enthusiast, 84%, but that's with the sim racing enthusiast, so he's normally 79. Feedback's not too bad, consistency blows, adaptability blows, everything else is pretty decent. 3 and a little bit of a star could potentially be a replacement for Sarah. I'll keep him in mind. Don't really. I'm not crazy about him because he's basically still. He's a Sarah replacement, but he's not much better than Sarah. Mia Holgerson. Bad at feedback. Lovely. Oh, that's only a temporary thing. That doesn't matter. Oh, catalog model. Okay, so normally she's 40. That's bad. She's 4 stars, 22, has no growth potential, but pretty nice stats. My only concern is the marketability, and also IGTC. Saruta, trading for pilot's license is only a temporary thing. Marketability plus 5, so a normal marketability blows. Other stats pretty nice. Ooh, potential 5 star. Only 19. Wasn't for the marketability. GTCS, she will talk to us next year. I'll keep her flag just in case she picks up anything that makes her permanently more marketable. That it? That's it. All right, continue on, and you're staying at home because you basically suck at the moment. Braking 3, smoothness 8, fitness 0, feedback 4, focus 8. Yes, no, just sod off. You don't bring anything to the table. Bjorn, you're up for the big one again. Sponsor select will be El Banco. We make it, we've got just over a million. Part fitting is done, and we are done. Join me tomorrow, if you would be so kind, when we will do the last ERS practice session and the last ERS race in the TM1 channel series ever. Hopefully. Until then, if you enjoyed this episode, click, like, subscribe, etc., etc. And I hope to see you tomorrow. Until then, have a great Saturday, and goodbye.